Microsoft believes in the power of innovation. Open source on Azure gives developers the freedom to develop code faster and more flexibly, all on a highly secure cloud platform, which is designed to protect your data and business assets. That's why our developer prefers using the Azure Open Source platform to bring her app to life. Hero Developer is excited to develop and deploy her app using open source technologies. She feels going the OSS route enables her to leverage the vast and rich ecosystem that it provides. A quick online search leads her to an Azure Docs page that tells her how to make an app cloud native. Our developer is familiar with JavaSpring and the corresponding ecosystem of tools and technologies for DevOps. She has her backend already written in JavaSpring, and with just a few changes, she can reuse it for this new solution. She is excited to see the wide support that Azure has for open source technologies, in addition to the investment that Microsoft is making in open source. She decides to start her coding journey using one of the simplest and most widely used IDE, which is VS Code, which has native support for JavaSpring development. She deploys the app using Maven to Azure Spring Apps, a first-class service that Microsoft built specifically for JavaSpring. Azure Spring Apps uses the Microsoft Open JDK, and our developer knows that if there are any issues with the Java runtime, Microsoft will fully support her. To monitor her Spring Apps, she then provisions Elastic Cloud offered by Elastic Inc. directly from the Azure portal. As an Azure native ISV service, Elastic offers the same experience as our other Azure services. As she looks ahead, our developer realizes that her solution will need an API and a web front end. She decides to use Python for the API and React.js for the front end. As she looks ahead, our developer realizes that she needs a cloud-native framework that she can use for her Python API. Reading the Azure well-architected framework, she also realizes that she needs to think about caching to build performant APIs. She comes across Dapper, which is an open-source CNCF project for building scalable and portable APIs and microservices in different languages. She finds that Dapper provides easy-to-use interfaces for common distributed computing problems, such as reliably calling other microservices, such as her JavaSpring app, and using technologies like Redis. The developer proceeds to update her Python API with Dapper in VS Code using the native Python extension. She also finds that Dapper is natively available in Azure Container Apps. She opens up her terminal, which can be inside VS Code, and uses the Azure Dev CLI to create Azure Container Apps, which provides an app platform on top of Azure Kubernetes Service and uses other CNCF projects like Kata, Dapper, and Envoy. Azure Container Apps provides a developer-friendly and app-focused experience for leveraging K8s along with the ecosystem around it to build and operate microservices apps in different languages. She can also create an Azure cache for Redis instance in the Azure portal and quickly configure her ACA instance to use it. She also recognizes that whenever she wants to ship some new features, she has to coordinate changes to different parts of her application. She decides to use GitHub Actions, as she keeps all her code in GitHub. From GitHub, she can deploy to Spring Apps, Container Apps, and SWA. She realizes that she has to load test her app before she ships the next version. She adds load testing using the Azure Load Testing Service that is built on JMeter. She can use JMeter scripts to hit the app, generate load, and see the impact of that in Elastic. Since her app is based on open source, our developer has the flexibility to work on Azure, on premises, or on her local machine. At any time, she can deploy her open source-based app to Azure using open source tools, frameworks, and services that Microsoft and Azure provide.